This is the Uptick Newswire Stock Day Podcast, sponsored by InvestorsHangout.com. Subscribe to us on iTunes, Google Play, and YouTube to stay up to date on penny stock news and interviews, public information on OTC, pink sheets, and microcap stocks from around the world, with your host, Everett Jolly.
On today's show, we have a returning guest, and I'm super excited to have her back on the show, and I'll tell you why. Back on November 30th, I told you about this company. It came on my radar about 3 or 4 months before November, and it was trading at around 1 cent, 1.2 cents. Now the stock's over 3 cents a share. We're talking no other than Progressive Care, Inc. I still think they're hugely undervalued. They actually upgraded to the OTCQB on December 5th of 2017, and they trade on the OTCQB. The ticker symbol is RXMD. And with us today is the CEO of that company. She's going to give us some highlights and where they're at and where they're going in 2018. That is Shital Mars. Welcome to the program, Ms. Mars.
Thank you for having me.
You know, I was telling everybody back on the show that you guys were undervalued at 1 cent. Since then, your stock's been up over 100% just in the first year of 2018. What do you think the contributions factors are?
So we've done a couple of different things since we uplisted to OTCQB, and that is to engage a couple of different companies to distribute and create content for us. So what does that entail? We hired Mass Ventures, where their principal is located on site, and what they do is distribute all of our press releases through our social media platforms and develop content in real time throughout the day. So whether it's taking pictures of our activities and posting them up on our Farmco website, getting blog posts, writing articles, they're constantly developing new content every single day and distributing that information to all of our followers and our shareholders and our investors and the public. We also engage Small Cap Voice. We also are working with you guys at Uptick, which we're really excited about, in getting our story out there. And we really think that since we're on QB now instead of the pink sheets, we believe that our story has a lot more credibility. We think that a lot more people are listening. And we think that by focusing on visibility and distribution and shareholder value throughout this year and especially towards the middle and end of the year, that we can really drive this company to the market value that we think it deserves to be.
You know, I saw a press release and I wasn't really sure if it said what I thought it said, so I really want to ask you, are you guys thinking about moving up to the NASDAQ?
Yes. So the ultimate goal has always been to become fully SEC reporting and list on NASDAQ. We think that that is the right place and the right path for us to go. And we think healthcare is ripe for that change. And we think that there's a lot of competition and opportunity in the marketplace for a company like ours to create something special and unique and worthy of being on NASDAQ. We also know that we want to have the right vehicle for it. So it's not something that we want to do just as we are today. We want to evolve into that NASDAQ-worthy company, and we're putting all the steps in place, all the factors, all the personnel and resources in place right now to get us to there as our end goal.
I want to recap for my listeners. You know, in 2017, you guys did over $20 million in revenue. Usually a market cap is anywhere from 4 to 6 times that, which would put you guys at approximately, you know, $80 million to $120 million. Your market cap's only around $14 million right now, if not a little bit less than that. What are some of the things you guys are looking to accomplish in 2018?
So one of the things that I'm really excited about is we're going to start dipping our toes and working really hard on some research and development and technological development. And here's a couple of things that we're working on right now. Obviously, we have our telepharmacy platform that we've been developing over the past year, and we've been doing our live streaming of our pharmacy to healthcare providers, to Century Village, where people can speak directly with the pharmacist face-to-face and get advice and consultation on their medication, get assistance with anything they need without having to step foot in the pharmacy. So that's one thing that we've been working on, and we think it's done wonders for patient satisfaction. It's done wonders for brand loyalty. It's done wonders for efficiency. The other thing that we're working on was we're trying to create a unified healthcare system. We think that a lot of the problems that we have in healthcare, a lot of the costs that keep increasing, is that there are gaps in information, that there are inefficiencies in how data is shared. So we think that by working with blockchain software and really working on things that will encrypt data back and forth between provider and pharmacy, and we can create one unified platform for data, that will help a lot of people get access to their healthcare and get access to their medication without having as many mistakes and have as much confusion as there normally is. So we're working on developing our own software for that. The other thing we're trying to do is get into research and development of CBD. And this is essentially cannabis oil or cannabis extract without the THC. It's available over the counter. And we're researching ways where we can implement this into our own compounds, where we can create something for someone with ADHD or even diabetic neuropathy or whatever else ailments a person might have, where we can research how cannabis can benefit that person
and benefit
their health outcomes. So we're trying a lot of different things, and we think that on top of all of the normal stuff, which is increasing sales, increasing profitability, expanding to new locations, increasing our foothold in the West Palm Beach area, expanding further north to Orlando, Tampa, that our research and development part is going to be a new and exciting piece that our shareholders are going to get really excited about, and we look forward to delivering some results.
I want my listeners to take a look at Progressive Care, Inc. I think the company is still grossly undervalued by a lot. If I put a fair value on it, I think fair value of the company should be worth north of 50 cents. Here in the next two quarters. But that's my opinion. That's one man's opinion. You can find them on the ticker symbol on the OTCQB, ticker symbol RXMD. Ms. Mars, what do you think that the most important factor to success this year, and how is that going to impact on what's going on in the healthcare industry?
So healthcare is constantly changing, and especially now. We don't know from one day to the next day what's going to develop, what's going on in the government, what's going on in major markets. We know that Amazon's getting involved in healthcare. We know that CVS and Aetna signed a major deal. And so what we have to do, and what Farmco and Progressive Care has always done, is stay focused on what its core strengths are, and that is expertise in healthcare, that is patient care, that is pharmaceutical management, and that is customer service. And we think those are the most important factors. We think that our ability to execute on research and our ability to develop our platforms, our ability to set up our own e-commerce platform that's capable of accepting any payment form, including cryptocurrencies, all of these things make a difference in how we develop and lead in the healthcare industry. And I think the important factors on top of what is our competitive advantages is to execute and to deliver and to really be on the cutting edge of what's next in healthcare and not be so caught up in everything being so uncertain. And we know that we can set up our own destiny, and we have always done that.
You've been listening to Shital Mars. She's the CEO of Progressive Care, Inc. They trade on the OTCQB, ticker symbol RXMD. In closing, Ms. Mars, is there anything that we didn't get a chance to touch upon that you would like to illustrate out there to the listeners?
I think that anybody listening and listening to our story and interested in hearing more about us should, one, look us up, go to our website, go to farmcopharmacy.com, see what we're about, and understand that we're not just a pharmacy. We're not just somebody who gets a prescription and dispenses it to a patient. We are a community pillar. We are a leader in healthcare. We are developing what it means to be a pharmacy. We are developing what it means to be a healthcare provider in today's age. And so I think that anybody listening should take a look at us and give us a fresh set of eyes and give us a chance to really show what we're made of. And I think we're just so undervalued. I think that even at 3 cents, we're worth so much more, and we've been worth so much more. And I'm pleased now that more and more people are beginning to recognize that.
Well, I want to thank you for coming on the show. I'm a huge fan of yourself and your company. Hopefully you'll come back on the show in about 40 or 50 days and give us an update.
Yes, I would love it.
This program is entirely sponsored and produced by Uptick Newswire, LLC, which is responsible for the content. The opinions and information provided on this program are those of the guests and those of the respective companies they represent, and do not necessarily reflect those of the staff or management of Uptick Newswire. Uptick Newswire encourages all listeners of this program to do their due diligence and research when determining investment strategies that will work for them, or to seek the assistance of an investment professional. The guests of this program may have paid for its distribution and are not directly affiliated with Uptick Newswire or the station.